Hello there, fellow space captains. It's Connor, and welcome back to another Fractured Spaceship Overview. Today, we will be taking a look at the Zarek attack craft, the Enforcer, the monster ship, the ship that just does not give any damns and tears every other thing apart in its path. It just wreaks untold bloody carnage across the battlefield. It really is an impressive ship, having a lot of fun in it. I did play quite a bit before the wipe. Whenever I first started playing Fractured Space, this was my favorite ship. And I forgot all of that. I really, really did. I just had no prior knowledge of playing the ship. But whenever I settled back into it, I settled back into just being able to tear things apart. It's a really, really nice ship. So, I mean, visually, it looks awesome. Somebody commented on a stream earlier this week that it looks like an angry crab. And it kind of does. I mean, there's the eyes and etc. It does look like an angry crab, but it does look menacing as well. I mean, see, personally, whenever one of these things jumps in close to me, when I'm in an Interceptor or a Reaper, I just crap myself. No matter what ship I'm in, if this thing gets on top of me as a Gladiator, I know I'm going to die if I have no support, because this thing will just use its escalate ability to rip through everything you've got. It's an amazingly terrifying ship, it really is. And, the entire ship's kind of built around its weapon system, which is the escalate weapon system, and I'll show you a bit of that in a moment, but let's go through the stats here. So its base hull strength is 9,000, which is kind of average. It's not too good, it's not too bad, it's just on point. Initial max speed, 570. I mean, you'd expect this thing to be as slow as the Hunter, but it's not. It's quite a bit faster than the Enforcer, in fact. Or the Hunter, sorry. Quite a bit faster than the Hunter. And it really does look like a Zarek ship. I mean, Hunter 470 initial max speed, this thing 570. You'd expect it to be slower than it actually is, but it's kind of on average with the speed as well. So, yeah, it does have a couple of abilities that help it mobility-wise, but, yeah, it's definitely not the fastest ship. So, let's read this little blurb of information and then get into the loadout. Enforcers are designed for close-range domination of important objectives. It can turn around a capture dispute and engage and trap escaping enemies. Its primary system is the escalate weapon system that increases damage with every shot landed. That's it in a nutshell. It really is. I mean, these little blurbs of info here are really on point. So first off, we have the escalate weapon system. Optimum range, 5,000 meters. Maximum range, 12,000 meters. Volley, 2 times 15, so 30 shots in total fired. And damage per shot is 3, unless you are landing every hit consecutively, which increases damage output by plus 150%. So, awesome. Now, the base cooldown is initially 9 seconds, but of course, when you level up, put points into damage, this will be lowered, and it's really then that things starts to tear everything apart in sight. Next, we have the taser beam. I'm not going to upgrade this. I'm focusing on the range boost. I've been told by a few people that the range boost is quite good. I have played it in a couple of games. I like it myself. But you have the normal boost available, quick boost. I've also heard that the normal default boost is the best as well. And I've toyed about with a quick boost. Personally, I tend to stick with a default one, but the range boost has got me out of a few sticky situations. So, yeah, the taser beam. So, range 12,000 meters, cooldown 30 seconds, duration 5 seconds. So, it disrupts utility, and I believe it also, you know what, we'll get down to the info in a second. The base cooldown for the ability is 30 seconds. The Zarek Systems Disruptor, more commonly known as the taser beam, is based loosely on the ESR disable system. The Zarek system fires multiple beams at the enemy, reducing the effectiveness of their engine systems by 50%. However, Zarek adjusted the system to simultaneously attack utility systems on the target, shutting down those systems for up to 2 seconds. So there we go. Pretty simple to understand. These here either increase one part or decrease another, so it's really down to your playstyle. I'll just stick with the base taser here, I'm happy enough with it. Boost, this is going to save your arse quite a bit. Is also going to allow you to catch up to some escaping fools who do not realize at that point that they're already dead. So it increases your speed by 5,000% for a duration of 6 seconds. This is the default one that increases it for 6 seconds. And the cooldown on this is quite long, actually. It's 100 seconds, so use it sparingly and use it wisely. Now, the quick boost, it reduces that time to 85 seconds, but it only lasts for 5 seconds, so it's a second less than the default one. And the longer one is 7 seconds, the duration, with an increase in cooldown by another 20 seconds. So it does have a long cooldown. I mean, 2 minutes there, it's pretty damn long, but it does save your arse. Blink to target. This is a really useful ability. I'm going to it pretty much lets you blink right to a target, but you have to be within 7,500 meters to be able to blink to them. So it is really useful. It also allows you to blink to allies. So just in case you're trying to get out of combat, you can blink to an ally who's a little bit further away, and it could possibly save you. I mean, the biggest cooldown for this is 27 seconds. It's not too bad. And finally, we have a cap mod drone, which increases your cap speed of gas, mines by 50%, and slows the enemy cap speed down by 50% as well. And of course, you can change this out for, you know, to slow the enemy down more, increase your speed more. It's really up to you and how you play. So there we go, that's the Enforcer. There's not really much to say on it, honestly, apart from that it also has my favorite skin in the game, the Cerberus skin. I think this thing looks awesome. I do like the Destroyer skin, but this thing just looks glorious. I really wish I had it. But let's get ourselves into a game. Minis online, 256, not too bad. So I have had quite a few people talking to me about this ship, how they like to play it, and I've had varying opinions, especially on the boost. That was pretty quick, actually. But I am sticking with the long-range boost. I've had three games or so in it so far, and it's alright. Short-range one, I think it killed me a couple of times. I really do like the default one, though. I've heard a lot of people say the default one's probably the best option to go with. Oops. There's Jack there. Titus's father, what the hell is he doing here? Right, awesome. Oh, here we go. Here we go. So what I'm really going to be trying to show you guys is how it works. So you've got your range boost. And that visually looks gorgeous. Just the burn of the engines there. I mean, at the speed of this thing, it's crazy. Gotta be careful as well that you don't run yourself into some asteroids or something. It can really ruin your day. Right, so 19 seconds until the battle starts. Not too bad. Right, so on our team, we've got myself in the Enforcer, Insis in the Persecutor, Ghost in the Colossus, Peril in the Protector, and Jack in the Enforcer as well. And we'll see what the enemy have in a moment. Let's have a look here. Right, beta. Guess I'm going to alpha. So in the enemy team we have Eamon 5000 in the Raider, Laser in the Raider as well. Whatever that guy's name is in the Leviathan, Capri Sun Lemon Drop in the Disruptor, and Samir in the Destroyer. Two Raiders, that's not going to go well for them, I don't think. I mean, the shield's nice, but that's about it. So are the mines. Is it the mines that thing gets? I really can't remember. Pretty sure it does. Oh, the Persecutor. Such a lovely ship. Look at that. Look at the detail. Look at how close in I am here with this old zoom feature. Look at the detail all close up. It looks so nice. It looks awesome. Titan defense systems. Oh, yeah. My main guys. Right, so we'll see if my cap mod for the center. Right, what have we got here? Destroyer and Leviathan. So you can tell that it's not the fastest ship, but definitely it is not the slowest ship either. Pretty much on par here with the Persecutor, although the Persecutor also has jump abilities. So let's get ourselves in here. So I'll wait for him to make his move. He has three blinks available, so I'll wait for him to do it. Oh, he's pulling back. They're pulling back. Trying to set up a defensive perimeter, but shouldn't be a problem. Is he going to blink? I guess I'm moving out with him. Here we go, taking down this Leviathan. Look at that damage the Enforcer's doing. Oh shit, I've lost the team yet. Stay on top of him, Connor. Stay on top of him. He's almost down. Keep up the fire. Come on. I can use the boost to get out of here. I have to take him down. Boost. Get my ass out of here. and I'm already gone. Awesome. And of course, the destroyer is quite long range, but his shots are falling a bit short just before they reach me. So here we go. And they're pushing us quite hard over a beta. That's the raiders. You see with their shields, forcing our guys to worry a bit and struggle. He's still firing at something. What's he firing at him? He's at a range. So I'm going to fall back here and help beat it. And there's three of them there. Surely they can handle two raiders and a disruptor. It's not that difficult. The enemy's capturing a station. I'm going to turn my arse around here. Get ready for the jump. What is that? It's a raider. Awesome. Dude, I can get right on you here. And now you're stuck. What are you going to do now, buddy, huh? Look at that damage. More than half his health gone with one escalated barrage. That's him down. So there we go, level 4 now. Going to keep pushing the advantage here. Where's that disruptor? Where is he? I can see his drones, but I can't see him. He must be around there somewhere. Yep, there he is. And he was there. So what I'm going to do is... watch this, watch this. Watch this. Look at that. Almost half his health gone in one barrage. Dropped himself there. Down goes the Leviathan. So this is definitely a ship for putting on the pressure and chasing down enemies that are a threat. That are, might just be quite out of others' range. So the raider's still hanging about there. I can see him. Don't worry about that. I can see him. I know he's there. Yeah, going to get behind this asteroid. Not going to let him. I think he's got the advantage here. Hopefully that'll disrupt. He'll try to jump out and he won't realize that. Hello? I have no idea what that dude's doing. Not even paying any attention to me. Wants to let his disruptor die, then he can die. Almost dead. Come on. Keep up the fire. And he's dead, just with a ram there. So if anyone's questioning whether or not can you ram, yes you can. Yes you can. Right. Elevate a bit here. Boost is almost off cooldown. Two ships after me. Raider. And the Leviathan. I'm going to hit hard here. So what I'm going to do is just... boost away now. Time to get out of here. We've done enough. I'm gonna fall back to base. Gotta go back to Alpha and stop the enemy from capping up. Or actually, it might be a better idea to go to Gamma. So I'm gonna jump into Gamma. Looks like they're all starting to bug out. Nice try, Leviathan, but not good enough. Alright, let's keep this up. So you can see, it might not be the fastest ship from just pure engine power, but it definitely does have quite a lot of mobility for itself. What with the... what's that? Is that another Leviathan? Oh, it's a raider. A little raider that's about to die. Oh yes, tasty raider. Need more of that in my diet. Missiles incoming. Where did the point defense fire behind me there? So watch this, he'll put up a shield, then I'll just jump right in beside him. Oh shit, what the hell's going on here? Why did I stop moving? These raiders, I don't think they know what they're doing. They keep going to the outskirts of the map. Or that's him out of the game. Get him, dude, get him. Yes. Oh, got a destroyer and a leviathan right on us. Start capping these mines again. Destroyers all alone. So I mean, with this ship, the Enforcer, see, going against bigger ships, it's just a matter of outmaneuvering them. I mean, get on top of them, get below them, get to where their gun arcs are very, very weak, and you can just take advantage of it, tear them apart. Keeping up the main caps, keep us ahead in levels, if even just slightly. Get back and level up, got a second attack to pick up. Right there, going back to our beta, so we're going to fall back again. Just keep up the pressure. The raider again. That raider is obsessed with RBS. Another jump completed. No, if he gets away, I'm so fucking angry. Come on. Shit! I've lost the enemy. Should have held off for just a second longer. That was a lucky jump out of there. I mean, these guys should be able to hold this in their own. I mean, they don't have as much firepower, what with having a protector, but still. We've got an Enforcer, a Colossus. Alright, so he's going to help. Alpha, that's alright then, it's just this lane then. A Leviathan and a Destroyer. Okay, it's not too much of a threat. And the Disruptor, that's a threat. Someone's jumping out. Let's do this. She lasts far too long, it really does. It needs to be reduced a bit. I mean, look at this. Oh, and he's gone. The disruptor's still up though, and that's a problem.
Power to their engines. I have triggered a short range relocation.
Can we keep up this fire here? Gone. Use my boost to get out of here. No problem. Hit and run. Get in there, kill something, get back out of the game. Turn around, repeat. So,
they are sitting
down. That shouldn't be a problem as long as the shields are down. Just need to stay within. Within that shield's range, come on. Yep, multiple targets on him now, he doesn't know what to do. The arc on these guns is horrible. Shit. Getting too hurry. That disruptor there's being a pain in my arse, so he's the new target. And he's way gone, he's away again. A little shit. You're a main disruptor. Oh, that's something you don't really want on top of it. There's two. Where the hell did he go? Well, there he is there.
The enemy has broken through our belly. This person is under attack.
He's going to get him and focus on this here Colossus. Or Destroyer even. Oh, there he is. What the hell? And they're all bugging out now.
No signal.
Right, he's on our protector. Not gonna happen.
We have completed Earthlink. Where's the current station? It looks like it is on screen.
Right, he's going down. Any second now.
They finish up in their tracks.
There he goes. Get into their base and start pushing them back a wee bit more. And we've got two levels to pick up here, so. Oops. I'm awful horrible at controlling this ship whenever it is boosting. Come on, damn it! I was going to try and blink into him and just finish him off, but nope, it wasn't happening. It was not happening. Not at all. Right, Colossus pushing forward with some Persecutor support. I would pretty much got this game in the bag. I mean, just over a level ahead of them. Protector's done one hell of a job this game. Peril. Look at that, 17 support points. I really don't understand the point of the Protector having the smart gun. I mean, it does nothing but tickle other ships. That's all it really does. Alright, he's getting himself out of there. You see that raider there? Look at Alpha. See the raider that's ahead, pushing towards our base? He is pissing me off, that guy. He's just trying to back cap us every freaking chance he gets, every time he spawns. So I'm going to put an end to that. Just to show him that it's not alright. See? Poax, dude, if you're watching this, what is your game? Like, it's not working. You've been trying to do it from the start of the game and it hasn't worked. Yeah, I get that, IX. I get that. I mean, this dude's shooting at the manning station here, even though he can't even get me.
Prepping jump drive. Please avoid combat. We have completed our jump.
I mean, Fractured Space has started to get me to hate the color green, because every time you see green in Fractured Space, you're just annoyed. I mean, half the time you're pleased to see it, and you're overjoyed. The other half you're just, damn it, stop healing the thing I'm trying to kill, damn it. He has been wrecked here. Come on. Yes. Leviathan, you are next, buddy. Well, this guy's fucking tanking it. Shit, I need to get out of here. I have no energy. I'm so screwed. Connor, you did a silly thing there. You weren't paying attention to what the rest of our team were doing. Damn it, and they got Gamma. That's not good. And a minute to wait until I can get back into this. Let's have a look at Jack and how he's handling the Iron Enforcer. It's handy having Jack here. I mean, whenever I'm dead, I can watch him. Look at those guns. They're gorgeous. They really are. There's no, guys, what are you doing? There's no point in hanging around Gamma. Especially whenever they've already got the buff benefit out of it.
The relocation was successful.
Right now, which wee shite? What was that? Boax again. Dude, you're obsessed with FOBs. Oh shit, he's got a friend. Doesn't bother me. Where'd he go? Fuck it.
I have activated blades. They are a city duck.
Why are you all still at Gamma?
This person is under attack. They're taking control of the station. The target stalled. We have successfully left. We lost power. Efficiency is down.
Guys, if somebody gets Gamma, if it's actually the enemy team, it benefits them if you hang about and let them kill you. So just don't hang about in Gamma. Get out of there as quickly as possible. If we have the buff, kill them off and then just push their base, whatever, if it's Gamma 4. Which is coming up pretty soon here. But, yeah, don't hang around unless you have to. They were just farting about there, taking on two heavies, even though they didn't really have to. I mean, a Colossus picking off a Leviathan with its flak would have taken far, far, far too long. Wonder where he's going. Take on bats. Where is Poex Eamon 5 going? He couldn't possibly be going for our cap, could he? I mean, that's the whole point of the game, but he's just forgetting everything else around him and going there.
I see the enemy.
Oops, sorry, asteroid. Didn't mean to hit you. Sorry, I'll get some flowers next week or something. Disruptor. Got you, disruptor. Hello. Oh shit, oh shit, oh shit. Got ya, got ya! Feck! Level 9 as well. Come on, end them. There we go, jacked. Awesome. So here we go, back into the war zone. Let's get in there. Start taking down some of these defenses while we make our way around.
Looks like it's on screen. Their actions have
Oh, and a beta disruptor. Awesome. I mean, look at our protector there. 28 support points. 29. Jesus. Could this be the win? Oh, come on. We're like 99%. There we go. Game is ended. One of the best games they've had in a long while. The Enforcer, the Zarek monster. This thing is awesome. And that was very, very enjoyable. And there she is herself, actually, the good old Overseer. Really do want to get that ship back. Such a nice looking ship, really, really is. Powerhouse. Right, so. Not too bad. And there we go. Not really sure what to call this video. Either the Zarek monster or the Zarek crab monster. Probably will be one of the two, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, very, very nice ship. It just screams Zarek. I mean, it's awesome. It is a very enjoyable ship. If you do like ships that are good at tearing apart other smaller vessels, I mean, you're not really going to take down like the Gladiator, Leviathan, Destroyer classes, big ships like that really quickly. But smaller ships like the Protector, you know, the Reaper, anything like that there, you'll be able to take down in at least a few clicks of the eye escalate. But yeah, it says here it's good for chasing down enemies as well, as you saw me doing there. It's a very nice ship. It's something I did not expect myself to enjoy again, but you know what? I really am enjoying the Enforcer again. It's probably my favorite Zarek ship apart from the Gladiator at this point. I mean, it's a very, 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 very good ship indeed. And was one of the first ships introduced, so it's got that going for it as well. If you've enjoyed this video, then you can find the link below to donate and support the channel. I would very much appreciate it. Also, I'm planning on doing more and trying to get these overview videos out more quickly, so you can look forward to more in the coming weeks as well. And again, I'd just like to say a thank you to everyone here who watched the video, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.